Functional hypothalamic amenorrhea. Functional hypothalamic amenorrhea is a form of chronic anovulation due to identifiable organic causes, but often associated with stress, weight loss, excessive exercise, or combination factors. Investigation should include assessment of the systemic and endocrine etiologies. The proximate cause of anovulation is functional reduction is a GnRH drive, which manifests as reduced LH pulse frequency. The reduced GnRH drive results in LH and FSH levels insufficient to maintain full folliculogenesis and anovulatory function ovulation. The neuromodulation signals that alters GnRH functions are many and include both inhibitory and stimulatory impulses that align GnRH function with internal and external milieu. There is a tight link between activation of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis and reduction in GnRH drive in those with FFA, including hypercortisolemia in both amenorrheic athletes and non-athletes. Exogenous endocrine disrupting chemicals such as bisphosphenol A and some polychlorinated biphenyls may affect the neuronal GnRH activity and Kasptin system throughout the modulation of GnRH gene transcription and the effects of estrogen agonist and antagonist. Revising amenorrhea by behavioral modification is associated with reduction in cortisol levels and disruption of ovarian function in some of the women with FFA. Kasptin is a G protein coupled receptor ligand for the receptor GPR54 Kasptin. GPR55 signaling plays a critical role in initiation of GnRH secretion during puberty. Kasptin neurokinin B dynorphin neurons within the arcuate nucleus secrete Kasptin, which stimulates GnRH neurons. Studies have reported that females with FFA have higher scores on scales of eating behavior, indicating a higher occurrence of dieting, bulimia, food preoccupation, and dietary restraints. A study using the frequent nighttime sampling has also reported higher cortisol levels in adolescent and young adult athletes with amenorrhea. The most insignificant acute risk factor of FFA include delayed puberty, amenorrhea, infertility, and long-term health consequences of hypoestrogenism. Typically, a longer duration of insult will result in a longer time of reversal and return to normal menses. The most significant chronic risk is of bone loss or inability to obtain peak bone mass. The uncoupling of bone turnover, including the suppressed bone formation and decreased resorption, is a unique, and although it can be reproduced by a short-term starvation in normal women, and it's not typical for loss but rather nutritional deprivation. Congenital malformation, septo-optic dysplasia, holoprosencephaly, and encephaly constitutional delay are the causes, with some genetic conditions, congenital deficiency of hypothalamic or pituitary transcription factor, single gene mutations of hypogonadotropic, hypogonadism, hyperprolactinemia, pituitary stalk damage, tumors with the cyst, hypothalamic or pituitary tumors, craniopharyngiomas, Rethke cell cyst, infiltrative disorders like germinoma, autoimmune disease, hypophysitis, sarcoidosis, hemochromatosis, tuberculosis, Langenson, histiocytosis, IgG-related hypophysitis, irradiation, infarction following the postpartum hemorrhage and Sheehan syndrome. Other causes in uterus include Mullerian degeneration, Escherman syndrome, synechia, pregnancy, infections, agenesis, in vagina, agenesis, transverse septum, and imperforate hymen. In thyroid, causes could be hypothyroidism, adrenals, congenital adrenal aplasia, Cushing syndrome, Addison's disease, ovaries, gonadal agenesis, ovarian insufficiency, autoimmune, oophoritis, radiation surgery, polycystic ovarian syndrome, and tumors. Overall, there are three main types: weight loss, vigorous exercise, and stress. Many studies have reported that hormonal alterations among the amenorrheic hyperexercisers compared with eumenorrheic hyperexercisers and non-exercisers, including the higher cortisol, and the secretions are blunted by elevation of FSH during the luteal and follicular transition, which may predispose to luteal phase defects. In adolescent or women with FFA manifesting an energy deficit, there is a spectrum of presentations and or diseases. The adolescents or women can thus range from the normal weight to severity underweight. Similarly, there is a spectrum of menstrual status that includes anovulatory amenorrhea, eumenorrhea, and subclinical menstrual dysfunction, luteal phase defects, and anovulatory dysmenorrhea or amenorrhea. Diagnostic evaluation for FFA in adolescents and women, those have menstrual cycle interval persistent exceed 45 days and those with present with amenorrhea for 3 months or more. Women with functional hypothalamic hypogonadism may also result from eumenorrhea and infertility rather than amenorrhea. Lastly, some women may have mild hypogonadotropic state that persists for many years and lower gonadotropic and sex steroid concentration that would be expected of their age. In patients with suspected FFA, it is imperative to elicit the history of galactorrhea, severe or persistent headache, nausea, vomiting, changes in vision, suggesting the possibility of prolactinoma or other prolactin or intracranial tumors. In addition to weight loss, FFA also manifests the symptoms such as bradycardia, mortal cold extremities, and double manifestation of hyperkeratinemia. In FFA, the thyroid function is similar to that seen of any chronic illness, that is TSH, free T4 levels and a lower range of normal, which generally reverses the normal weight gain and psychological recovery. Testosterone will be in lower range of normal and prolactin and will be low normal range. IGF-1 is a nutrition-dependent factor that stimulates osteoblasts, functional and bone formation, and can be another useful factor to measure, especially in the case of FFA with low bone mass. After excluding the pregnancy, it is suggested that administering a progesterone challenge in patients with FFA to induce withdrawal bleeding as an indication of chronic estrogen exposure and ensure the integrity of the outflow tract. Options include medoxyprogesterone acetate, norethindrone acetate are important. Brain MRI is recommended in adolescents with a presumed FFA and history of severe persistent headache. The baseline BMD measurement by DXA in an adolescent woman with 6 or more months of amenorrhea and that the clinicians obtain in early and those patients with history of suspicion of severe nutritional deficiency. In the cases of primary amenorrhea, we suggest evaluating Mullerian tract abnormalities, congenital or acquired. Diagnostic options include physical examination, progestin challenge, abdominal or transvaginal ultrasound, MRI, depending on the context of patient's preferences. Hysterosalpingogram, sonohistogram, saline infusion sonogram, hysteroscopy to establish the acquired gynecological tract abnormalities. FFA and PCOX may coexist and the patient recover from FFA manifest PCOX may emerge including the irregular menses. The clinicians should evaluate the patient and inpatient treatment for FFA and severe bradycardia, hypotension, orthostasis or electrolyte imbalance. In adolescent and women with FFA, we recommend correcting the energy imbalance to improve HPO excess function. This often requires behavioral change. At least 6 to 12 months of weight stabilization may be required for the resumption of menses. In some cases, the regular menses may never resume after the weight stabilization, emphasizing the importance of psychological factor and stress. In adolescent women, FFA, there is psychological support such as CBT. And oral contraceptives for the sole purpose of gaining menses or improving BMD. In patients with FFA using OCPs for contraception, we suggest educating the patient regarding the fact the OCP may mark the return of spontaneous menses and that bone may continue to lose, particularly if the patient maintains energy deficit. The short-term use of transdermal E2 therapy with cyclic progesterone contraceptive is recommended. The optimal type of estrogen and optimal estrogen replacement dose, bone and other tissues deserves further study. Thank you.